It's just a break.
Bass and The Berg.
Are we ready? Bass and The Berg, are we ready? Are we ready, guys?
Pod.
Number 16. Welcome back, guys.
Let's fucking
As
go.
Per usual, check out the bio for all the socials.
We're going to be on Twitch a little bit recently.
Yeah, we both bought the new 2K.
Mm-hmm.
We are on current gen, sadly, so we don't have the cool player comparison shit, and I can't hang on the rim like you can in yeah.
It can't be that hard to just let me wiggle around.
Yeah, when I saw that, I was like, damn, that's cool, and then I realized, and then also, in my league, the My Eras isn't there either, which is cool, because you could do, you know what I'm saying? You could do, that's not in, it's not
I feel, in. Like, the smaller stuff like that, I feel like can't be that hard
to... they could have done the era stuff, I feel. Yeah. I feel like they definitely could have done that, but...
It's okay. But we'll be on Twitch.
Either way, yeah, we'll be on Twitch, streaming the new 2K here and there, doing whatever.
We posted a new video in the middle of the week.
Yes, sir.
We did our...
little live stream for the 2000s.
And we posted little highlights, part one. We have part two out next week.
Yes. More to come.
Thank you guys for checking it out.
Yes, sir. Appreciate it, guys. Appreciate it.
But not too much personal news.
No. Nothing crazy. No, I'm finally moved in at the... Well, I've been moved in, but I'm finally, living at the...
Mm.
At the place. That's about it.
I feel buying the new 2K is the biggest news.
Honestly, it's the biggest thing that I've done. Yeah. Honestly. It's a commitment. It's also 110 gigabytes on my PlayStation.
It's literally crazy. It's
a very large amount. Yeah.
I just delete the old one. Yeah, I think I had to delete Madden also.
Yeah, I deleted an old, I had Madden 21 downloaded still, so I deleted that. I had deleted a couple games for it, but...
Yeah, it was...
Didn't take as long as I thought it was going to take to download, but... It's fun.
My internet's pretty trash. Yeah. Even though it's in my room.
Yeah, it's right there, yeah.
I think it was 6 hours.
Damn.
7 hours.
Damn. You see, that's what I thought mine was going to be, but thankfully, I didn't know. Ours is, pretty decent, because we have a bunch of people on it too.
Yeah.
And there's, multiple devices as well.
It was just my mom.
So I was...
My mom and I.
Yeah.
it took 7 hours.
Yeah. No, mine took, especially two, honestly, because Jaden just randomly turned on my PlayStation when it was in rest mode. He's like, "I thought it was off," and I was like, "Nah, it can be in rest mode." Cause I don't know if it downloads quicker, but I always think it does, so I just put it in rest mode.
I don't know.
But it took a lot quicker than I expected.
Yeah, not bad at all.
But the new 2K it's fun so far. I've only played a little bit of it, but
we're gonna be cool. Playing some more on stream.
Yep.
Check out the Twitch.
Yes, sir.
The Twitter. The Gram.
Mm-hmm.
The Spotify. Thank you. Any Spotify listeners who jumped on.
Shout out to the Spotify listeners. The day ones.
Yeah,
anybody jumped on?
I don't think there are.
I don't think there are either, but it's still cool.
Thor, thank you. But let's talk some news, Bass.
Get straight into it.
Let's talk some good news to start off. A little update on what we talked about last pod. the Suns owner. Terrible guy.
Yeah, Robert Sarver is announced he has started the process to sell both franchises, the Mercury and the Suns. He's very in nice. The beginning process. Yeah.
Did you see that the possible buyers was Jeff Bezos and
a group? No, I didn't see that. No, I didn't.
It was a couple hours ago. I was just scrolling through and it was Jeff Bezos and a partner group may buy the Suns and Mercury.
Oh, that'd be. But, okay, whatever.
He just said he was going to sell it today, so...
Exactly, yeah, it's super... Mm-hmm.
I mean, it's an interesting little rumor.
Yeah, but I mean, Boj is saying, the Suns are considered an extremely desirable franchise in the marketplace that have no shortage of a high-level ownership candidates.
Because
since the executive always believed this could be a monster free agent destination with right ownership. I mean, you have Devin Booker, so... Yeah, I think,
Good, exciting news for the Suns.
Yeah, it's better getting rid of a trash owner. Hopefully you get some... Because, like, you know, the team is still good, so you get a better ownership in there, and just... Hopefully that just makes the team even better. Honestly, that's what I would hope would happen.
It will.
But,
You're getting a better environment.
Yeah, overall.
Everything kind of clicks a little
nothing,
better.
There's none of that bullshit, like, looming over or anything like that, but... Yeah.
Agreed.
Yeah, whatever, Adam Silver. I fully support the decision by Robert Sarver to sell the next, this is the right step for the organization and community. Okay. Yeah, yep.
Very good, very good.
Yes, it is. Yes, it is.
But keeping on the good news train, I forgot about this until a couple seconds ago. Congratulations to the Las Vegas Aces.
I saw. Shout out them.
Yeah.
Congratulations
to them.
They
looked like they were having fun.
They were
sauced.
She said something.
She's like, if you don't, you gotta be four shots deep.
Yeah, four shots deep to pull up. Yeah, and she's like, should I have like 5-6 bottles of champagne? And I was like, shit, as you should. Winning a championship, fuck it. Do what you gotta do, man.
But
you got there. Yeah. You won that shit.
Congratulations to the Aces.
Shout out to the Aces. Big shit. Good for them.
But sad news time.
Yeah, it's sad news. Back-to-back injury time.
Guy that you guys know I love. I've talked up this offseason. It was Alonzo Ball.
Yep. Yep.
He's hurt 4 to 6 weeks out.
Yep. Undergoing an arthroscopic debridement of his left knee.
May.
Got the first thing right, but I didn't struggle with the second word. But, like, I feel like he just keeps struggling with... It's just an error, a setback. I just want to see him play, man.
Yeah, really, at this point.
I just want to see him play.
You know he can. It's just hard to just be, like, waiting.
Yeah,
waiting
waiting. Literally every time I feel... I'm not even a Bulls fan. I just like how... Because Lonzo... I just like how Lonzo plays. Yeah. He's just a good player, and it just sucks to see...
Yeah, it was really exciting.
Injury after injury, and just to see how he would, I don't know, just improve, just see it, because I can't remember the last time that I've seen him play. But, sad news, but, you know.
I mean, 4 to 6 weeks from today.
Yeah, he'll be reevaluated
in
4 to 6 weeks, so we don't know.
I think it's just like a miss the beginning of the season thing.
Yeah, thankfully. It's nothing too crazy. Yeah. But knock on wood, it's nothing.
It's still upsetting to see.
Yeah, for sure.
But we also have more injury news from players we're excited about.
Yeah, Robert Williams. Yeah, he's going arthroscopic procedure on his left knee and is expected to need 4 to 6 weeks to recover. Yeah. He had a meniscus surgery in March and played through the playoffs. Yeah, we'll keep him out minimally of the Celtics training camp and preseason, but... The cleanup on his left knee is expected to have him back in the lineup early in the regular season. So, nothing too crazy.
Thankfully for both of them, it's not crazy.
Yeah, nothing. No minor setbacks. Just obviously disappointing now. Yeah. And it'll take him a little longer to get, into game shape and shit like that. And, really.
Celtics being bit by the injury bug.
Yeah.
Gallinari, Al Robert.
Yeah.
Hopefully that's not a consistent thing
I hope
for them.
Not. Yeah, no, I hope not, because Robert Williams is like one of their guys. Yeah, he's a dog. He is a dog. He is a Celtics dog, for sure. He's a big part of their, honestly, whole team. I was going to say defense, really? But honestly, he does a lot for them. But shout out Robert Williams. Sounds like he'll be chilling in 4 to 6 weeks, so... Speedy recovery for both of them.
One last news segment. The Anthony, we didn't talk about it last pod.
No.
But he said some things on his Instagram story.
Yeah, he said some...
If you want to look that up, we're not going to be
talking
about the video.
No, we're not going to be... But
he was...
Not saying what he said.
He was fined... But was it by the Timberwolves or the NBA?
Yeah, Timberwolves guard have been fined $40,000 for using... does not say...
If you check the comments, I think there's a really cool video.
Yeah, there's a video underneath it. Really cool, this is something like Bass and The Berg, so I don't know. It's not saying who... I'm assuming it's the NBA.
Yeah.
I'm assuming, just because it's, he used derogatory language on social media. I mean, I would think so. Or maybe the NBA made
Yeah, the Timberwolves. But either came or, from the top, but yeah, either way, or, he's yeah. he's owing money.
Yeah.
But yeah. Hopefully, he's a young kid, learning experience. He kind of can be like, hey, I should not have used that kind of language and kind of grow from it.
Yeah, just not.
Thankfully, it wasn't like a hardcore.
Yeah,
like,
it wasn't. Yeah.
Horrible. I mean, it wasn't good.
But no, I'm not, it wasn't, no, it wasn't like, good, but it could have been a lot worse. Yeah, it could have been a lot worse. But I'm not, like, giving him the excuse that he's young. I'm just saying he has time to grow time as a person. Like, he's, you know, made a mistake, obviously. I don't know if he's come out and said anything about
He had a tweet a couple hours after.
Yeah, but I don't know what he said in that tweet or anything like that. Idea. Yeah, I don't know if he... I kind of want to find that now. Yeah. I don't really want to dwell on this topic that much, but...
But we actually have some NBA news this week. It's exciting. Not always the best news, but sometimes some good news. Yeah. I know last week was a little light. No, I burped really hard and really hurt my chest.
Oh, no.
Oh, my God. But while Bass finds a tweet, we'll talk about... We're doing another draft today.
Yes, another, sir.
We're moving to the 90s, going back in time. You know the big names. Michael Jordan. Hakeem Olajuwon. Ron Harper.
Ron Harper, okay.
Detlef Schrempf.
Detlef Schrempf. Okay, I found what Anthony Edwards says. He said, "What I said was immature, hurtful, and disrespectful. I am incredibly sorry. It's unacceptable for me or anyone to use that language in such a hurtful way. There's no excuse for it at all. I was raised better than that." I mean, that's a good response.
He knows.
I mean,
he knows what he did was wrong.
He knows he fucked up.
Just hopefully he can grow from it.
Yeah. Make this be a learning experience and not to do anything like that again. Because don't want that to fuck up your whole career off of some stupid shit.
Yeah, some bullshit you want.
And it's also like on social media. It also just goes back to social media. Like, no need to even post that.
Yeah, really. There's.
Like, I don't know. Like, you know you're in the NBA, man. You know you're, like, low-key a super... Like, it could be a superstar. Mm-hmm. You know, have the makings.
A lot of people look up to you and...
Yeah, have the makings for it, and then... There's just no need. But... That's the best response I feel like you can have. Yeah. Just be like, yeah. Taking full accountability.
Really not much else to say about
it. Yeah,
you
can't say much, but... Alright, let's get off of that.
But, Bass, you want to do the spinnies for us?
Ah, yes, we can do the...
John is, the, 2-0.
2-0, yeah. Very
going Kobe.
Very annoying.
Mike Conley.
Yeah, well, it's a fall off, but, you know.
No. Yeah, Kobe was a rough pick. I don't know. I don't know if he can live up to Mike Conley.
Shut up, John. No. No, no, no.
All respect to Kobe, but I don't know if he can live. He'll always be in Mike Conley's shadow.
Okay, all right. I'm spinning the wheel. Spinning the wheel.
Go on, 3-0.
No way! Let's go! Let's go! No. Last second nail biter. Bass pulls through with the victory. Let's go! Okay. Let's go!
Bass goes Michael Jordan. I go Hakeem Olajuwon. Bass, we're back to you.
Hey, you don't know that, John.
Okay, who are you gonna go pick?
No, it is
Michael Ron Harper.
No, it is Michael Jordan.
Harper.
Come on! How could I not pick Michael Jordan? Hold on, give me a sec. I just want to write down my
Ron Harper,
my actual team. Because I have all my guys, but I don't have, like, the little slots for...
Yeah.
Sorry, bad podcast guys. Sorry.
I did have mine set up before.
Yeah, John did. Like, I have my whole thing set up. It's just, you know, okay. All right, yep.
Yeah, so...
Michael Jordan.
I go Hakeem. Yeah, John goes Hakeem.
All right.
Go watch some Hakeem little... Shake,
yeah, his dream shake. Yeah, if you've never watched Hakeem highlights, I don't know why you haven't. But yeah. Like,
even if you're not a basketball fan,
even if you're not, like, just watch. Like, the, it's almost art.
It really is.
It is. I will confidently say that it is art to see Hakeem Olajuwon.
Just
how tall he is.
Pure body control.
And the movements and the foot control and mm-hmm. the, oh my
the
god.
Speed.
Yeah, the footwork and the speed and mm-hmm. the. Just the
it's
agility.
Gorgeous. It's gorgeous
just,
to watch.
It's a very beautiful thing. It would have been nice to see him live, if that could have been. I mean, you know, we get to see a discount. I don't want to say discount, but Joel is not.
Yeah, he's no.
He's not Hakeem Olajuwon, but he's, you know, Hakeem-esque, you know, mm-hmm. in the way he plays, you know what I'm saying? The ball movement, you know. Just the way he moves with the ball. He's very versatile for a big man, but.
Maybe. if I had to list people that are similar to Hakeem,
yeah,
like Joel and Jokic would be like 1 and 2. Because I don't know anyone else who really has the...
Yeah, I was going to say, just like the post control and just like... And the footwork.
And Jokic kind of has that, like, not in the same way, like, in the post as much, but in just the way he is able to be that big man that has the mobility.
No, he can move, and, like, the type of shots he, like, gets off, and they're, like, janky random shit, and they still go in. I know what you're saying.
Like, and if you're a Hakeem, you have to have that good vision and that good play style to know when you can hit that jab, when you can hit the spin, and Jokic has that in a way through, like, his passing his playmaking ability. So
I can see that, yeah. And just because I feel like that there hasn't been any bigs that move with the ball as similar to Joel and,
We haven't seen B-Ball Paul play this year yet.
That's true. Yeah, we haven't seen a prime B-Ball Paul, but he has the makings for it, obviously. Yeah, he has the makings. He's a little bit shorter, obviously, but I think that'll help with his ball handling. Mm-hmm. And that'll be no problem, because we'll have, like, an 80-inch vertical, he's literally going to jump out of the gym, so that'll be fine. He'll be fine there.
Hakeem late.
Yeah, honestly, yeah.
At least now, and then we'll be saying Hakeem is B-Ball Paul late.
Obviously. All right. That's enough. That's enough Hakeem talk.
Second pick. I'm hoping.
This is kind of. I mean, I think. Yeah. Who do I want to go with? Because it's like, do I want to take a big man right now? Mm-hmm.
That's my decision.
Like, or it's like, do I?
We got Barkley on the board. We got Scottie Pippen. Yeah. We got Clyde. We got Gary Payton. Sean Kemp. Do you want to add a center? Because I'm David Robinson.
You know, I'm gonna go with David Robinson. Because I literally looked up his stats and he averaged like 30 and like 10 essentially as a center.
The Admiral.
Like I knew he was good, but I never like really looked up his numbers. Mm-hmm. And I was like, holy, like he literally averaged like his rebounds might even
hit
be
that,
more.
But hit like, that quadruple double too.
Exactly. Yeah. But like literally, I was like, God damn. Like that is an insane stat line for a big man. And he can move.
This puts me in a predicament.
Why, did you want David? No?
No. It's just, I think now we've hit the fall off. Those first three guys are like the top tier. The top tier players.
What you mean, yeah. Because now it's like, these guys are good.
Guys you could put in the game that will break the game.
Yeah.
Now we're going the guys that are going to get in the game and just take it over, but not break the game, you know what I mean?
I know what you mean.
It's not disrespect.
No, I'm not disrespecting any of these guys, but...
Charles Barkley.
Okay.
Charles Barkley.
I low-key wanted Charles Barkley. Barkles. I also looked up his numbers, and I was like, God damn.
Charles Barkles.
God damn. Damn.
It was tough.
Damn, I wanted him.
Because I like Scotty.
Yeah,
but I'm not super big on Scotty.
Yeah, I know.
And I would take Barkley over Scotty like 10 times out of 10.
Yeah.
So?
Actually, no, I am going to go Scotty Pippen. Michael Jordan never won without Scotty Pippen. So I got to pick up his right-hand man if this team is going to do anything.
I mean, I would pick Scotty next. Yeah, like, I'm not saying like it's a huge drop-off.
Yeah, because like, I'm just thinking it was like him... Yeah, because defensively, I was gonna. It was like him or Sean Kemp, but I'm mm-hmm. like, I like Scotty's defensive ability more, personally. What is John looking up? John
tall,
Mid.
How tall is Sean Kemp?
Bon Bemp, 6'10".
Okay. How tall is Barkles?
He's like 6'6", 6'5". Yeah, Barkles was extremely undersized, mm-hmm. but he didn't play like it. He played bigger than his, his size. What is John thinking for your fourth pick?
Yes.
Your fourth pick.
I'm moving Barkles to small forward.
Barkles to small forward.
And taking Sean Kemp.
Sean Kemp as my power forward. Okay, gotta take Sean Kemp off the board.
Because if you took Barkley there, I was happily going to take Sean Kemp.
Yeah.
But if I can have both Barkles and Sean
Kemp. Yeah, you can have both, yeah.
There was someone I did have in mind there that I'm hoping is there for my next pick, but I am not too sure they will be.
I'm gonna have to sag him now. I'm taking Young Shaq.
Oh, okay. That was good. That was good.
It's fun. I got my big man rotation. Okay, I'll take Young Shaq, Young Orlando Magic.
Mm-hmm. I like it. I'm gonna go a guard here. It's between two.
Okay.
Do I want a lockdown defender?
Yep.
Or do I want a flashy, fun guy that's gonna get you a lot of points?
Okay.
We're looking at Hakeem, Kemp, and Barkley. I think my defense is pretty good.
No, your defense is...
I'm going to go Clyde.
It's set there.
Go.
Okay, Clyde. Okay.
Clyde Drexler.
Oh, man, I thought Clyde was going to slide low-key.
There's no Clyde slide here,
but... I didn't think so. I didn't want to disrespect Clyde like that, because he was going to go in the next... He was going to go this round.
Yeah. And if Bass not on the same wavelength, I think I know where... Possibly.
I don't know.
I'm going to rate my guess... Best in life.
Okay. You got your guess down?
Yeah.
I'm picking Penny Hardaway.
Nope, I was wrong.
Who'd you say?
My pick. Gary Payton.
Okay. Pick Gary Payton. Yeah. I was gonna pick Gary Payton, but...
No, I liked the Penny pick.
Penny. I had Penny. I don't know.
Guess you're not getting anywhere against this top five. This defense is clamped down.
I mean, okay, I got pretty good defenders as well, but...
My defenders are better.
Okay.
I completed my starting five, and I was going to stay in my starting five.
Starting five.
Gary Payton at point guard. I'm throwing Clyde as shooting guard. Barkles, small forward.
Barkles.
Sean Kemp, power forward. And Hakeem, the dream. And center. A lot of versatility here. Clyde could be a big guard, small forward.
For sure. Yeah.
Barkley can play the power forward. I like it. I like it so far. Bass on the board. Deep thinking.
I'm gonna go Derek Coleman.
Okay.
I don't know. I don't really want to take another different power forward at this point.
Yeah. No, I respect that.
Yeah.
Cool. Derek Coleman, Penny back-to-back. It's a little underrated back-to-back combo.
I
guess.
I mean, I like the Penny pick, but the Derek Coleman is... he was like a 20-10 guy.
Yeah.
I'll take it. Well, I mean, I don't know if this will be my starting five, but right now I have Penny, Michael Jordan, Scottie Pippen, Derek Coleman, and David Robinson.
I mean, if you really think about it, you can literally put whatever team you want around it, because you do have Scottie Pippen and Michael Jordan.
Yeah, I do, yeah.
So you could just pick 90s bums if you wanted to.
Yeah, I'd be okay. That's what they did in real life, be fun. So I'd be okay. I think this team will be okay if I get... I'm not going to say anything.
I know what you're thinking. And you're thinking, Bass.
Do you?
Yeah.
I think you do, goddammit.
Well, it's not this pick I'm about to say, okay. I don't think.
Okay, I hope not.
I need to add some shooting to this team.
No.
Is it Reggie Miller?
No, don't say Reggie Miller, no.
Reggie Miller added to the team.
God damn it, I should have picked Reggie. God damn it,
best
dude.
Best shooter of his era.
God damn it, man.
Gotta add some. So this is if we're doing this in 2K, we gotta get those three balls going. But that's not my main thought. I just wanted Reggie on my team.
That just hurt.
It was an extra help.
That just ruined me.
Sorry, Bass. Reggie just fits this team.
Yeah, I know. I just don't know of any other three-point shooting guys in the 90s.
What's Mitch Richmond's?
Yeah, that's what I'm looking up.
What's his three ball look like?
That's the only who I was about to pick.
Grant Hill?
He's not a shooter.
Could be. Think about it.
I don't really want him right now.
Think about it a bit.
Let me look at Mitch Richmond, because he was top on my list. Oh, okay. That's actually really good. Oh, okay.
It was between Reggie and Mitch for me.
Okay, yeah, I'll happily, okay, I'll take Mitch Richmond. Actually, I'm actually not that mad about that.
I like it.
I just looked up his shooting splits, because literally, he has a season where he averaged, where's the best three? He shot fucking, like, 43% on six threes, and he averaged, like, 26, and that was in 96-97.
Yeah, that's really good.
Okay, so I know it's not Reggie Miller, but that's enough, that's...
It's a very shooting. Good pick that's when good Reggie shooting. Miller's not on the board. Yeah. I like it a lot.
I definitely could have, should have, because I don't think you were gonna pick Derek Coleman.
No,
I could have stuck with a Derek Coleman. I just wanted to fill out my starting five, so I was like, it is what it, I'll take Mitch Richmond. Honestly, I like Mitch Richmond.
I don't think it's that bad of a
downgrade. It's not as bad as I'm thinking. I just like,
yeah,
it's Reggie Miller.
It's Reggie Miller. All right. What am I thinking? I'm thinking that I need to circle back around and go to the bigs at Alonzo Mourning.
Okay. Yeah, that's fair. I got my big man out the way already. Yeah. I got David and Shaq, so it's okay. I'll be straight down there.
I'm not against Alonzo Mourning. Hakeem Alonzo's not a bad
one. No, I like Alonzo. Alonzo Mourning, I looked up his, he was good too. He was like a top five big of the 90s, easily.
I feel bad not picking Patrick Ewing, because I kind of like Patrick Ewing.
It's just because he's on the Knicks, personally. I just couldn't. He was really good. I'm not disrespecting Patrick Ewing. I know he was very... He was the whole reason the Knicks were good in the 90s. Like, literally the only reason.
What about Allen Houston?
I did look up his stats, but I was like, not Allen Houston. I'm going to go Chris Webber.
Nice.
Because he had, like, one season right before the cutoff. Let me find it. And it was, like, an insane season. I was like, yep.
Webster? Webster's Dictionary?
Yeah, Webster's Dictionary, yep. He went crazy.
How could you make that into, like, an actual nickname? Webster's Dictionary.
You know, like, he averaged 20, and he averaged... Fucking 13 rebounds.
Okay.
In 98-99.
That's not bad at all.
And I was like, okay, did he shoot the three at all? No, not really. Oh, well. I'll take a 6'10 baby Kevin Durant, kind of. I'll call Chris Webber that. I'll say that.
You know what? We're going big defense on this team.
Big defense, okay.
We have the character. We got a little more character.
I think
Dennis Rodman.
Yeah.
Rodman.
Wanted to take Dennis Rodman, but...
Rodman come off the bench.
Yeah.
That's nice.
Yeah.
I think that's definitely the perfect role for him in this setting.
Yeah. I was going to pick Dennis Rodman or Chris Webber the last round. So I was like, I didn't want to just have the entire Bulls team on my... Was it really?
That's what I thought you were going for. I thought you were just trying to.
I mean, I could have, but. But then I thought about the shooting, and I was like, I already have David Robinson and Shaq for rebounding. Derek Coleman can kind of rebound. Chris Webber had a 13 rebound season. I know it's Dennis Rodman, but. I'm like, yeah, I'll be okay. I got Scotty and MJ. It's okay. Yeah. They won without Rodman, so it's okay.
It wasn't as good, though. Dennis Rodman.
Fair enough.
How many picks in are we? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 picks in.
Yeah, 2 picks left. Okay.
Let's make it.
You want to do more? We can do more.
12.
Okay, we can do more. Because I have people, I just didn't know. Because I just need a backup point guard and a backup small forward.
Same here.
Do I go...
Does he do it?
Do I go him or do I go...
Who's he going to go for? Is it him?
I don't know if I like him, though.
He doesn't know if he likes him, though.
Like...
Deeply?
Yeah, he had good scoring seasons.
Great scoring seasons.
Yeah, but I kind of like this guy a little more.
That guy's a little better.
I mean, not, like, realistically, but...
Yeah, if you think about it.
I feel like he's a better overall player. I mean,
yeah, overall, you gotta think about that.
He was like the LeBron before LeBron.
LeBron? We're talking LeBron here? Yeah, already in the ninth round?
Yeah, I'm going to go Grant Hill.
Okay. No, I guess so.
Grant Hill there. I'll take it. I don't know. Yeah. He does a little bit of everything.
Yeah, but we got LeBron. Michael Jordan and LeBron on the same team.
I mean, he had a season. He averaged, that was in the 99-2000 season, so technically not. But he had seasons before that where he averaged 21, like 7 rebounds.
Yeah, if it wasn't those injuries.
He had a 9-rebound game, 9-rebound season, I mean. And then also, above 5 assists.
It's not bad at all.
So, if he didn't have injuries, that would have been, because he was very solid. I'll take it.
I'm going to go also small forward here with the human highlight reel, Dominique Wilkins.
Yeah, it was between him or Grant. I might get some hate for not picking Dominique Wilkins, but...
I mean, if I'm looking at my bench, I got the down low locked. I got a shooter. Now I got a good 3 as a slasher.
Yeah.
I can really get in there. So I'm liking.
I'm fucking with my team. Backup guard. Let me just make sure.
Just making sure.
I think I want.
Oh.
Tim or him.
Guys, don't forget to leave a like on the video, like a subscribe, share to everyone. While Bass is thinking intensely.
I don't really know if I like him, though. But, I mean, he had decent season in the 90s. His prime really wasn't the 90s, but...
LeBron James.
I wish.
Right before the 90s.
I wish.
Right, how old would LeBron be in, 99? How long did you take, a 15-year-old LeBron?
Right now. Hey, might as well. Damn, I don't know. I don't really have another, guard that I... What about this guy? What about this guy? How tall is this guy? Oh, wait, he can play this. Oh, I'm going to take Joe Dumars.
That's a good pick. He was on the outskirts of mine.
Yeah, he was... I'll take him. It was going to be him or... Isaiah Thomas for me, but... Isaiah Thomas was kind of better in the 80s.
Yeah, he was an 80s guy.
I looked up Joe Dumars' 90s numbers. It's pretty solid. He had 20... almost 4 point... I'll take it.
And I was right.
And he kind of shot the 3. Oh, he kind of shot the 3. Okay.
It would be a 15-year-old LeBron. So, 15-year-old LeBron is in the running if we do think he's better than someone that actually played basketball in the 90s.
I mean, honestly, that's freshman year Bron? I feel like I've seen freshman year Bron. He's pretty good. He's pretty good. I don't know,
man.
I don't know. I mean,
I'll let slide.
I don't know.
Alright.
That'd be that'd be Gordy. Okay, so have our team.
Yeah.
And now it's just
I gotta grab a point guard to finish it out.
Oh yeah, we have to.
Will go.
Yeah, who are you gonna go?
Kevin Johnson.
Okay. He was.
One of the most boring basketball names I've ever heard in my life.
Yeah, but he was solid.
Right next to Larry Johnson.
Yeah.
No, he was great, but I always think less of him because his name is just so boring.
That is true.
Hakeem Olajuwon.
Yeah, and then just Kevin Johnson.
Charles Barkley. Those names kind of are big. They grandpa.
Yeah.
Clyde Drexler. But it's Kevin Johnson.
I'm Kevin Johnson.
Larry Johnson.
I'm Larry Johnson. Yeah, hell no.
So let's say our 5 real quick.
Sure, 5. Yeah.
So point guard, Gary Payton, and then as I just said, Kevin Johnson, Clyde, Reggie at shooting guard, Barkley, Dominique Wilkins, small forward, Sean Kemp, Dennis Rodman, Hakeem, Alonzo Mourning. Those are my 10, and they're better than Bass's.
Yeah, I'll say I like your team a lot. But my point guards, Penny Hardaway, Joe Dumars, shooting guard, Michael Jordan, Mitch Richmond, small forward, Scottie Pippen, Grant Hill, power forward, Derek Coleman, Chris Webber, and my centers are David Robinson and Shaquille O'Neal.
That's deadly.
I like my big man rotation. It makes up for my lackluster power forwards.
Yeah, your centers are great, and I love your, like, I know it's Michael Jordan, but the Mitch Richmond addition really is, like, really solid. I really like that as your shooting guards. Yeah,
I like the you know, Joe Dumars and Mitch Richmond, because I don't know what, because, like, Tim Hardaway was also, like, in the running for me, yeah. But I'm like, eh, he's more of a, I don't know, offense, he's, I don't know. Joe Dumars is 6'3", I just wanted a bigger guard. I know I have Penny, too, but... Isaiah Thomas is also like 6'1". Tim Hardaway's like 6 foot, so I was like, eh.
All right, Bass.
So how many subs are we doing?
Three. Doesn't matter. Do you want 2 or 3?
We'll see. Yeah, I guess. Yeah, we can do 3. I think I have enough people for 3. I hope so, yeah.
I think I also do.
I hope I... Yeah, I have enough. Yeah, I'll be okay.
All right. Who you got, Bass? Who's the best pick? Leave your guess in the comments. I was gonna be that cringy YouTube guy for the rest of the video.
Nah, I'm gonna bolster up my centers more. I'm gonna take the Dikembe.
Nice. Also, fuck. I wanted the Dikembe.
I like Bezza in a rotation.
That was very solid.
I'll take my. fucking David Robinson, Shaq, the Kembe Mutombo.
That's literally fucking crazy.
Have fun with that, John.
No.
I'm surprised that he was, because obviously he's a good center, but he's not like, he's up there obviously, but
I don't know.
Actually, no, I have a couple. Okay, I have people.
We'll go.
I need to look these guys up though.
What position do I think they'll be stuck? Maybe my shooting guards. Maybe my small forwards.
Well, I think I know who I'm going to pick next. If John is a big one. I don't think John's going to pick. I don't know. We'll see.
I'm going to go... What position is the guy I just looked up? Okay. So I could wait on that.
Wait on that.
And I looked it up. He is 6'6", so he can play the small forward. I'm going to go Larry Johnson.
Okay, Larry Johnson. Okay.
Got the Johnsons.
Yeah, John got the Johnsons.
Got big old Johnsons on my team.
Big Johnsons.
Big Kevin Johnson.
Big Kevin Johnson.
Big Larry Johnson. I have my next pick. Already set up. I'm ready.
I'm gonna go Glenn Rice.
I was just looking
at him. Because he had a season where he averaged goddamn 27
Damn.
And 47% from 3 on 5.6 a game, and he has multiple seasons over 40%. So I was like, he was a shooter like that? He was a shooter like that? Which I'm fine. I didn't think I really had shooters, but now I have Mitch Richmond. Now I have Glenn Rice. I'll be okay.
You know what, Bass? I'll change my pick and go shooters too, because I've just kind of.
Because I might take another guy as well.
I'm gonna pick Detlef.
Detlef Shrimp. Okay, he almost made my list. He almost did.
It was between him or Danny Manning. I kind of forgot about
Danny Manning. Okay, he was. I saw him on a couple lists when I was looking shit up, and I was like,
I feel like just I need a little bit more.
Yeah. No, I don't hate that at all.
So last pick.
I'm trying to see. I just want to get like another shooter, but I don't know. I don't think I can't go him. Do I have another shooter on this? What did this guy do? What position is this guy?
What is he?
Oh, he's 6'7". Never mind. And he's not a shooter. Let me just double check this guy's.
Unless you pick him.
Shooting splits.
I feel like there's a chance here.
I mean, it's okay. I like the scoring though.
Okay.
Yeah, I'm gonna go Chris Mullin.
That's a great pick. I literally completely forgot about Chris Mullin.
Did you actually?
Literally.
Chris Mullin. I'll take that.
That's a great pick.
He was. You know, good in the 80s, but, like, even in, like, the beginning of the 90s, he was, like, 3-time All-Star. Yeah. He averaged damn near 26 and pretty good shooting split. I mean, the three is not amazing, but he shot 45% one time on three of the game, so I'll take it. Above average three-point shooter.
It's pretty good. It's a good last pick. It's
between him or I was going to take, like, a young AI. Okay, because if you look up Allen Iverson's, ass, hold on, let me bring him up. That season right before, 98-99, he averaged 27 points. So technically,
it would have been allowed.
But no, he was just kind of like he was my Sixers guy at point guard. I was like, yeah, I throw him on.
I'm gonna add a 2-year Sixer legend.
2-year Sixer legend.
3 and D. Like, 1 year with Utah, played 82 games for them. 46% from three.
Who is this?
46%.
Oh, I was going to go him. Dude,
Jeff Hornacek.
Dude, John, literally it was between him. I literally looked up Jeff Hornacek and Chris Mullin. Yeah.
That's why I was scared you were going to take him. I was like,
no, because I looked up both of them because I was like, and then I was thinking, I was like, I can't pick this guy.
But he's a two-time NBA three-point winner.
Yeah.
He retired his jersey. I did not know that.
I didn't know that either. Yeah, but he has a lot of good seasons. Yeah, he does have a 46% season.
I was not expecting that at all. Yeah, and a 43.
Yeah. I mean, there's
a 44.
Yeah, there's a 42. There's a 44. Yeah, very good, very good.
And like, a steal and a half to two steals.
No, I was going to say, yeah, good defensively as well. Yeah. At least a steal and a half every game. No, Jeff Hornacek, he made my list. I was like, I might. I'll take Glenn Rice's. I didn't know 47%.
I like that Glenn Rice pick.
Chris Mullin, yeah.
We got some solid bench pieces.
Yeah, I like my bench, guys. Pull throughout the bench for sure.
Yeah, rounding out. Guys. A point guard, Gary Payton, Kevin Johnson. Shooting guard, Clyde, Reggie Miller, Jeff Hornacek. Small forward, Charles Barkley.
Mm-hmm. I'm mad I didn't get him. I'm gonna keep.
I'm being. So happy I got Charles.
I was because I like.
It feels great to have
Charles. I know because I was like. I mean, I know I have Michael Jordan.
Mm-hmm.
But just as a Sixers fan, and just how Charles Barkley is, and you're gonna have to like make him in 2K. But, I mean, they'll have if you look up his name on the player DNA, they'll be a pre-made. People already have made him. Sorry, I interrupted.
Dominique Wilkins, Larry Johnson. Power forward, Sean Kemp, Dennis Rodman, Detlef, center, Hakeem, and Mourning. I can put Kemp at center.
No, I was going to say, Rodman you could put center. Kemp, yeah. How tall is Detlef Schrempf?
I think he's like 6'10".
6'10", okay, yeah.
That's a rule.
Because I was
looking him up.
Yeah, I was looking at him too, because I was like,
yeah. Yeah, 6'10".
6'10", okay, yeah.
From Germany.
Yeah, Germany.
Sixth man of the year.
Can you pull up his stats?
Yeah.
I know, it's just very random. I just want to see.
No, you can never get enough.
Yeah, Detlef Schrempf.
Where's the basketball?
Basketball reference. Why is that not here?
Basketball.
There we go. There it is. Like, why was that so difficult?
Two-time sixth man, three-time all-star, all-NBA team in 94.
Ah, damn. Let's go see the stats. Yeah, okay. Okay,
between
yeah, very solid,
15
yeah.
and like 19 in his prime.
Yeah.
Three point.
It got better.
51% on 82. He played every single game and hit it.
On 2 threes a game.
I don't give a fuck, guys.
On 2 threes a game. All right.
51%.
Glenn Rice shot 47% on 5.5 a game. 5.6, okay?
That's fine.
And he played 78 games.
Yeah. Those four games is where he really messed it up.
I don't care, my guy. And he averaged 27 on 47. I don't care, John.
Who?
Shout out Detlef Schrempf, though. Yeah. Okay, I'm going to say my team now. Point guards. I have Penny Hardaway. Joe Dumars. Shooting guard. Wait, how tall is Glenn Rice again?
6'4".
So he's like a small forward. Okay.
Is he?
No, he's not. He's 6'8". shooting guards, I have MJ and Mitch Richmond. And I'm sorry, I don't know Chris Mullin's position either. I know he's taller, right?
Definitely a small forward shooting guard.
Oh, he's 6'6", so he... Okay, he could play... Okay, so he could be a small forward or... Okay, but small forward, Scottie Pippen, Grant Hill, Glenn Rice, Chris Mullin could play shooting guard or small forward, need be. Power forward is Derek Coleman, Chris Webber, and center, David Robinson, Shaq, and Dikembe Mutombo.
Literally crazy.
I love my... I wanted to have really good centers because the 90s were dominated by great centers. Mad I didn't get Hakeem, obviously, but it was him or MJ, obviously. I mean, you could debate, but, you know, it's fine. But getting David Robinson and Shaq.
That's...
And Dikembe...
Literally fucking crazy.
Yeah.
That's why I got some shooters.
Yeah.
We don't need to push inside as much.
Yeah, I know. Yeah. Yeah. I got some defender, though. I got MJ. I got Scotty. You know what I'm saying? That's about it, Those are my only defender. I feel like... I don't know if Derek Coleman's a good defender. I don't know if Grant Hill's a good defender.
I'm pretty sure they both were solid.
Yeah. So, like, I don't know if Joe Dumars was a good defender. Like, I don't think Mitch Richmond was a good defender.
I feel like definitely Joe Dumars was. I'm looking up Grant Hill.
Let me look up Joe Dumars.
Yeah, Grant Hill. Early career was averaging like 2 steals to 1.5.
Okay, yeah. Joe Dumars was a 5-time all defense. Yeah. So, yeah, I think I... Okay. I have some decent defense.
Let me look was up, Derek Coleman.
Yeah, Derek Coleman. I know Chris Webber did not play good defense, really.
Derek? Coleman. Yeah. Almost at 1.8 is his highest, but
One block a game. About a block a game. Okay.
Throwing in some steals in there.
Yeah, in his prime, he's, you know, like 20 and 10 guy. I mean, Chris Webber has, like, he's a total rebound champ 1 year.
Yeah.
Actually, no, I mean, early Chris Webber has, like, Chris Webber. He has a couple... No, he's a couple. He's a 1.9, 1.7, 2.1.
Yeah, it's not a bad pick.
And then steals, he has 1.7, 1.6. Okay. I was just thinking defensively. I don't know. Yeah. I don't know if, I know Mitch Richmond. I just need to look up Mitch Richmond again. I know Mitch Richmond, not,
It's not, I don't know if that was the focal point of this game.
No. He's 6'5", yeah. Yeah, no, he's 5-time all NBA, but, I mean, he averaged about in his prime about a steal and a half a game.
That's not bad.
That's not bad, but I took him more for his scoring, personally. But
yeah,
okay.
Yeah, but it's a nice little, you know, it's there.
Fine. He can still be. He'll be still. I'm just thinking like just 2K terms.
Yeah.
I know real life doesn't really. I mean, yeah. But Joe Dumars is okay. That's fine. I assume Joe Dumars was a good defender.
Mm-hmm.
But all right, I fuck with my team. I like it a lot. I like both of our teams.
Leave a comment who's going to win. Leave a
comment who you think, who y'all got.
We'll definitely do the stream with this again.
Yep.
We'll stream it.
Put in 2K and we'll see what happens.
Yeah, well, if you miss the stream, put it on YouTube, release the little best bits.
Yeah, you'll see the best, I guess we can say the highlights of some sort, of it, if you don't catch the stream.
Yeah. Any closing thoughts, Bass?
No, I don't think so. No, I'm excited to put these teams in 2K and see what's going on with it. See how they. I just like to see how like my team, because I know I don't have like that many shooters, so it's like.
But I also am I'm lacking the big man defense. Yeah, at least that's in comparison to your team.
Yeah, to my
So maybe that will kind of cancel each other out.
Yeah, but I'm just thinking like across the league, you'll be fine.
Yeah.
You'll be fine. I'm just thinking like current day teams, you'll be okay. You have Hakeem Olajuwon. You'll be okay. But, against each other.
Because we'll make it to the finals.
I will have a hard time scoring.
And I'll try not to
this team.
Put us in the same conference
again. Yeah.
And I'll edit the schedule a little bit so we play each other a little more often.
A little more, yeah. Yeah, so it's more entertaining. So it's not just like three or four games in the whole season. You have to
wait
the whole
time. Or like one or two if we're in separate conferences.
Yeah, it's so stupid. Yeah, it's so stupid.
Thank you guys. All right,
thanks again for watching, guys. Yep.
Check the description.
For all the socials. Yes. Check them out, please. Yes, drop a like, subscribe, drop a comment. Y'all know. You know what YouTube is. If you like the video, you know what to do.
Bye.